positive. If I've got to run down there and get them for you myself, I will. Are we good? Hey, we are live, and quickly I'm going to take a drink of water. Thank you all so much for being here this morning. For those of you who are joining us in person, if you are a guest, thank you for being with us today. We are overly excited to have you. For those of you who are joining us online, thank you as well. We hope that you are safe and doing wonderful wherever you're streaming this. If you don't mind, let's all stand up this morning and begin with some worship. Good. I've heard a thousand stories of what they think you're like, but I've heard the tender whisper of love in the dead of night. You tell me that you're pleased and that I'm never alone. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. I've seen many searching for answers far and wide, but I know we're all searching for answers. Only you provide. You know just what we need before we say a word. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are, and I'm loved by you. It's who I am, it's who I am, it's who I am. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. To perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways. You are perfect in all of your ways to us. Love so undeniable, I can hardly speak. Peace so unexplainable, I can hardly think as you call me. Deeper still as you call me. Deeper still as you call me. Deeper still into love, love, love. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am. You're a good, good Father. It's who you are. It's who you are. It's who you are. And I'm loved by you. It's who I am. It's who I am. It's who I am.
You can be seated.
Good morning and welcome to Hunter Hills. Welcome to church today. I'm so glad to see you all. To all of our visitors, welcome. And to those watching online, we're so glad that you're joining us from wherever you are. We have a few things going on in the life of our church family that I wanted to share. with you all today. First, next Sunday is the Super Bowl, in case you didn't know, very important Sunday. And the teens are going to gather here at the building at 5:30 for a Super Bowl party. So we hope that you'll join them here next Sunday for that fun party time. And then if you are a parent of a baby through a child with a child through fourth grade, babies through fourth graders, parents, we're going to have a parent meeting next Sunday in the multipurpose room at 9 a.m. And if you can't join us in person, that's totally fine. We're going to have another meeting, the same meeting, at 4:30 that day on Zoom. So it was originally 6. If you made plans to join us, we moved it to 4:30 because of the Super Bowl. I overlooked that fact. So make plans to join us next Sunday at either 9 or 4:30 if you're a parent. We'll reflect on the past year, what we've learned. We'll look forward to this year, talk about our calendar, and some things we can all do together to get through another year. And then finally, we're really excited as a church family to journey through the season of Lent together again this year. Lent is the 40 days leading up to Easter. And last year, we had a guide that we gave out to everybody, anybody who wanted to do it. I think some small groups did it together and families did it. We're going to do that again, and that starts with Ash Wednesday on February 17th. So we're going to gather here at the church Wednesday, February 17th, for a service, for an Ash Wednesday service. We'll have nursery, but otherwise it will be a church-wide, family-friendly, interactive service here in the auditorium. So we hope that you'll make plans to join us for that. And then pick up a Lent guide that night, and we'll do that all season together. So that's all I've got for you. Before we begin worship today, I wanted to read a psalm. I have a call to worship of sorts from Psalm 146. It says, praise the Lord, O my soul. Let us praise the Lord as long as we live. Let us sing praises to God all of our lives long. Do not put your trust in princes, in mortals, in whom there is no help. When their breath departs, they return to the earth. On that very day, their plans perish. Happy are those whose help is in the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord their God, who made heaven and earth, the sea, and all that is in them, who keeps faith forever, who executes justice for the oppressed, who gives food to the hungry. The Lord sets the prisoners free. The Lord opens the eyes of the blind. The Lord lifts up those who are bowed down. The Lord loves the righteous. The Lord watches over the strangers. He upholds the orphan and the widow. But the way of the wicked he brings to ruin. The Lord will reign forever, your God, O Zion, for all generations. Praise the Lord. Let's worship together.
Stand and sing.
There's nowhere else that I'd rather be than dancing with you as you sing over me. There's nothing else that I'd rather do, Lord, than to worship you. So rejoice, be glad, rejoice, O my soul, for the Lord your God, he reigns forevermore. I rejoice, for my God reigns. So rejoice, be glad, your father and your friend is the Lord your God, whose rule will never end. I rejoice, for my God reigns, my God reigns. And I dance the dance of praise, my God reigns. And with a shout I will proclaim, my God reigns. My God reigns, and I will rejoice, for my God reigns. There's nowhere else that I'd rather be than dancing with you as you sing over me. There's nothing else that I'd rather do, Lord, than to worship you. So rejoice, be glad, rejoice, O my soul, for the Lord your God, he reigns forevermore. I rejoice, for my God reigns. So rejoice, be glad, your father and your friend is the Lord your God, praise, my God reigns. With a shout I will proclaim, my God reigns. And I worship without shame, my God reigns. And I will rejoice, for my God reigns. And I will praise him, you heavens and all that's above. Praise him, you angels and heavenly hosts. Let the whole earth praise him. Praise him, the sun, moon, and bright shining stars. Praise him, you heavens and waters and skies. Let the
Oh no, what's he gonna do? So a few days ago, Stephen asked me to do communion thoughts. So naturally I asked, well, what's the sermon about? And a few minutes ago, I find out there is no sermon. But the sermon was going to be about parenting or children or something. He didn't give me a lot of information, so this is all Stephen's fault. and Paige's too, because she married him. But I didn't have enough time to come up with like a replacement speech or whatever, so I'm just going to give you the original. Anyways, this topic should be somewhat relatable to all of us. I'm assuming that most of us used to be kids at some point. Some of us, I doubt it. Like Joe Beal over there, you can't tell me that guy wasn't made in a factory. Sometimes you just zone out, start thinking about existential questions like, why doesn't the glue stick to the inside of the bottle? I don't know. But all jokes aside, this is communion time. So I apologize that what I just said was not related to anything for the rest of the service. But I did make you laugh, so. If you haven't gotten your little communion thing, now would be a good time to get it, because everyone's about to take it, so you're going to be, like, by yourself if you don't. But that's the end of my speech. Come to the table.
pray with me real quick. God, we love you so much, and we are honored to be in a place where we know that you are present. And we are thankful that you are here with us. And more importantly, we're thankful for Jesus who came to earth, became a human like us, perfect human, unlike us, but who makes us perfect in his way. Thank you for his body that was crucified on a cross and his blood that was shed. And as we take this communion, this bread and this cup, help us to remember that sacrifice. In Jesus' name, amen.
I need now under your wings, cover me within your mighty hand. When the ocean tries and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you. Find rest, my soul, in Christ alone. Know his power in quietness and trust. When the ocean tries and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. When the ocean tries and thunders roar, I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are king over the flood. I will be still and know you are God. I will be still and know you are God.
And God, we're thankful. We're thankful for reminders to be still, for big, loud storms and strong winds, for things like that who make us look up and say, that is God, and help us to always see those things and to stop and be still, because there can be beauty in a storm. There can be your beauty in sometimes destruction. Thank you for being here this morning. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, I am going to go ahead and dismiss our children, ages 3 to kindergarten. Did I do that right? Yes. So, guys, didn't mean to be inclusive. Guys and girls, if you want to start making your way back there, where are you going? We got to sing another song. Oh, she's 3 through kindergarten. I forgot. For the rest of us here, let's stand up and sing another song.
Before I spoke a word, you were singing over me. You have been so, so good to me. Before I took a breath, you breathed your life in me. You have been so, so kind to me. couldn't earn it. I don't deserve it. Still, you give yourself away. All the overwhelming, never-ending, reckless love of God. When I was your foe, still your love fought for me. You have been so, so good to me. When I felt no worth, you paid it all for me. You have been so, so kind to me. Oh, the overwhelming, never. Deserve it, still you give yourself away. Oh, the overwhelming, never ending, reckless love of God. There's no shadow you won't light up, mountain you won't climb up, coming after me. There's no wall you won't kick down, lie you won't tear down.
Brandon alluded a moment ago, there's no sermon today, so don't worry, I'm not going to be speaking. What has happened is Stephen's dad, Paul Evans, was slated to be a guest speaker this morning. He was going to talk to us about parenting, but Paul's wife, Stephen's mother, just tested positive for COVID. So obviously it was not wise for Paul to come here, but we also want to pray for Stephen's mom's quick recovery. So that left us a couple of shepherds and thought leaders and worship leaders scrambling to fill time. We could dismiss you early, but there's no fun in that, right? So what we decided to do was put together a group of scripture readings and songs that correlate to those scripture readings. So you're going to hear from some different voices, some different passages. We're going to sing some songs. We didn't really discuss standing versus sitting, so I'm going to make an executive decision here and say, you do what you want to do. If we're singing a song that you love and it's touching your soul and you want to stand, Miss Lula, rock it, okay? Stand up and sing it out, okay? If you want to remain seated and contemplate the words that we've just heard and the words that we sing, that's fine too. So you're free to do you. Is that good? Can we do that? Yeah. Sure. All right. Let's rock. So our first scripture reading, I think, is going to come from the voice of God.
Many are saying of me, God will not deliver him. But you, Lord, are a shield about me, my glory, the one who lifts my head high. I will call out to the Lord, and he answers me from his holy mountain. I lie down and sleep. I wake again, because the Lord sustains me. I will not fear, though tens of thousands assail me on every side. teeth of the wicked. From the Lord comes deliverance. May your blessing be on your people.
Thou, O Lord, art a shield about me. You're my glory. You're the lifter of my head. Thou, O Lord, art a shield about me. You're my glory. You're the
Psalm 118, 19 through 24. Open for me the gates of the righteous. I will enter and give thanks to the Lord. This is the gate of the Lord through which the righteous may enter. I will give you thanks, for you answered me. You have become my salvation. The stone the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. The Lord has done this, and it is marvelous in our eyes. The Lord has done it this very day. Let us rejoice today and be glad.
My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only trust in Jesus' name. My hope is built on nothing less than Jesus' blood and righteousness. I dare not trust the sweetest frame, but only trust in Jesus' name. Christ alone calls. Dressed in his righteousness alone, faultless stand before the throne, Christ alone, cornerstone, weak made strong in the Savior's love, through
Psalm 124. If the Lord had not been on our side, let Israel say, if the Lord had not been on our side when people attacked us, they would have swallowed us alive when their anger flared against us. The flood would have engulfed us. The torrent would have swept over us. The raging waters would have swept us away. Praise be to the Lord, who has not let us be torn by their teeth. We have escaped like a bird from their fowler's snare. The snare has been broken, and we have escaped. Our help is in the name of the Lord, the maker of heaven and earth.
Had it not been the Lord who's on our side, had it not been the Lord who's on our side, the anger of the enemy would have swallowed us alive. Had it not been the Lord who's on our side. Blessed be the Lord who would not give us up. Blessed be the Lord for his unfailing love. The snare is broken and our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the Lord. Had it not been the Lord who's on our side, had it not been the Lord who's on our side, the water would have engulfed us. We would have surely died had it not been the Lord who is on our side. Blessed be the Lord who would not give us up. Blessed be the Lord for his unfailing love. The snare is broken. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the Lord who would not give us up. Blessed be the Lord for his unfailing love. The snare is broken. Our help is in the name of the Lord. Blessed be the Lord.
From Psalms 125. Those who trust in the Lord are like Mount Zion, which cannot be shaken but endures forever. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people both now and forevermore. The scepter of the wicked will not remain over the land allotted to the righteous, for then the righteous might use it for their hands to do evil. Lord, do good to those who are good, to those who are upright in heart. But to those who turn to crooked ways, the Lord will banish with the evildoers. Peace be upon Israel.
As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. Surround us, Lord. Surround us, O Lord. We need to be in your presence. Surround us, Lord. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. As the mountains surround Jerusalem, so the Lord surrounds his people. Surround us, Lord. Surround us, O Lord. We need to be in your presence.
I'll be reading Philippians 2, 1 through 11. Therefore, if you have any encouragement from being united with Christ, if any comfort from his love, if any common sharing in the Spirit, if any tenderness and compassion, then make my joy complete by being like-minded, having the same love, being one in spirit and of one mind. Do nothing out of selfish ambition or vain conceit. Rather, in humility, value others above yourselves, not looking to your own interests, but each of you to the interests of the others. In your relationships with one another, have the same mindset as Christ Jesus, who, being in the very nature God, did not consider equality with God something to be used to his own advantage. Rather, he made himself nothing by taking the very nature of a servant, being made in human likeness. And being found in appearance as a man, he humbled himself by becoming obedient to death, even death on a cross. Therefore, God exalted him to the highest place and gave him the name that is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue acknowledge that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father.
And I'll be reading from 2 Corinthians chapter 5, verses 17 through 21. Therefore, if anyone is in Christ, the new creation has come. The old has gone, the new is here. All this is from God, who reconciled us to himself through Christ and gave us the ministry of reconciliation. That God was reconciling the world to himself in Christ, not counting people's sins against them. And he has committed to us the message of reconciliation. We are therefore Christ's ambassadors, as though God were making his appeal through us. We implore you on Christ's behalf, be reconciled to God. God made him who had no sin to be sin for us, so that in him we might become the righteousness of God. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every tongue confess. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow at his name. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every tongue confess. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow at his name. He is the wonderful counselor. He is the mighty God. He is the everlasting Father. He is the Prince of Peace. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every tongue confess. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow at his name. There is no other name, no name by which we're saved. There is no other name but Jesus. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. At the name of Jesus, every tongue confess. At the name of Jesus, every knee shall bow. Every knee shall bow at his name. Every knee shall bow at his name. Every knee shall bow at his name. He became sin, who knew no sin, that we might become his righteousness. He humbled himself and carried the cross. Love so amazing, love so amazing. Jesus Messiah, the name above all. Blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel, the rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord. For sinners.
All our hope is in you. All the glory to you, God, the light of the world, Jesus Messiah, the name above all names, blessed Redeemer, Emmanuel. The rescue for sinners, the ransom from heaven, Jesus Messiah, Lord of all, Jesus Messiah, Lord.
This is great worship, right? Amen. Our last reading comes from Revelation 5, and it's a lengthy passage, but it's a great, it's a beautiful vision that was given to John the Revelator. And after I finish reading this lengthy passage, please stand for this last song. And I saw a scroll in the right hand of the one who was sitting on the throne. There was writing on the inside and the outside of the scroll, and it was sealed with seven seals. And I saw a strong angel who shouted with a loud voice, "Who is worthy to break the seal on this scroll and open it?" But no one in heaven or on earth or under the earth was able to open the scroll and read it. Then I wept because no one could be found who was worthy to open the scroll and read it. But one of the 24 elders said to me, "Stop weeping. Look, the Lion of the tribe of Judah, the heir to David's throne, has conquered. He is worthy to open the scroll and break the seven seals." And I looked and I saw a lamb that had been killed, but was now standing between the throne and the four living beings and among the 24 elders. He had seven horns and seven eyes, which are the seven spirits of God that are sent out upon every part of the earth. He stepped forward and took the scroll from the right hand of the one sitting on the throne. And as he took the scroll, the four living beings and the 24 elders fell down before the Lamb. Each one had a harp, and they held gold bowls filled with incense, the prayers of all of God's people. And they sang a new song with these words: "You are worthy to take the scroll and break the seals and open it, for you were killed, and your blood has ransomed the people of God for every tribe and language and nation and people. And you have caused them to become God's kingdom and his priest, and they will reign on all the earth." Then I looked again, and I heard the singing of thousands and millions of angels around the throne and the living beings and the elders, and they sang in mighty throngs, "The Lamb is worthy, the Lamb who was killed. He is worthy to receive power and riches and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and blessing." And then I heard every creature in heaven and on earth and under the earth and in the sea, they all sang, "Blessing and honor and glory and power belong to the one sitting on the throne and to the Lamb forever and ever." And the four living beings said, "Amen." And the 24 elders fell down and worshiped God and the Lamb. Please stand.
Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he. Sing a new song to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Holy, holy is he. Sing a new song to him who sits on heaven's mercy seat. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to Kings. You are my everything, and I will adore you. Clothed in rainbows of living color, flashes of lightning, rolls of thunder, blessing and honor, strength and glory and power be to you, the only wise King. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are Jesus, your name is power, bread and living water, such a marvelous mystery. Holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all holy, holy, holy is the Lord God Almighty, who was and is to come. With all creation I sing praise to the King of Kings. You are
know if any of you had a chance to meet my brother-in-law last week. He was here to worship and spend a couple days with us, and so I ended up taking him hunting for a couple days. And on Monday morning, I took him to my favorite spot, and that spot, I've seen a couple does all year, spike or two, that's about it. And about 10 minutes after daylight, a really good buck comes out, and he shoots that deer. And I just had to hug him and say, I am so happy for you. Bless his heart. I'm so happy for him that he did that. But it was a reminder that for me to be happy for others. You know, we live in a selfish and self-centered world where we're competing with each other, and it's hard for us to really say with genuineness, hey, I'm really happy for you. And it makes me think about what our week should look like this coming week. In Philippians chapter 2, I was so grateful for the reading earlier, but if we go a little bit further in Philippians 2, verse 14 says, do everything without complaining or arguing, so that come blameless and pure children of God, without fault, in a crooked and depraved generation, in which you shine like stars in the universe. When do we shine? Not while we're arguing or complaining, not while we're competing, not when we're not happy for someone else's success. We shine like stars when we're thankful. Instead of complaining, being thankful for what we have. Instead of arguing with each other, encouraging one another. Let's pray. Father, we are so grateful to you for an awesome day, God of praise and worship, of remembering Jesus, our Lord and Savior, around the table. Father, we are so encouraged by the encouragement of our hearts and in song and by the reading of your word. And Father, your word is so powerful, and we are so grateful to you for that. God, help us this week. Help us, God, to be a people that shine like stars in the universe. Help us to be a people, God, that are grateful for everything that comes our way. Help us, God, to shine when we give encouragement to those around us. Father, help us to shine when we don't complain about something, when we feel like we have every right to. Father, help us to shine this week, and not so others lift us up, but God, so that you are glorified and it draws others to you. God, we are so grateful to you that we are holy and blameless through the blood of your Son and our Savior, Jesus Christ. And it's in Jesus' name that we pray. Amen.